The UFO phenomenon has fired our imaginations for 50 years. The very idea of alien beings and spacecrafts from another planet, another galaxy, holds us mesmerized.
We want magic. What flying saucers do, over and above the question of are they real, is that they bring that magic back. We take all the old myths and wonder, wrap them in shiny stainless steel dish-shaped machines.
Most of those who believe haven't actually experienced anything themselves. They buy into UFOs because of a few dozen blurry images. But what are they really seeing? This photo, for example, is one of the most famous in the history of UFOs. Over the years, this shot and another taken moments later have been examined many times. No one has ever found any telltale signs of fakery, no retouching or darkroom funny business. But even if they're real photographs, they're not necessarily photographs of a real UFO. To challenge the seemingly unassailable evidence of UFO photographs, we decided to find out how hard it would be to make our own believable UFO photos. Did we go to Hollywood's special effects experts? Not exactly.
This one.
Meet our crack team of alien spacecraft designers. These youngsters gathered a hodgepodge of things you could find in any home.
The bottom's one of those cake tin things.
The kids mixed and matched all the stuff with a little imagination, a glue gun, and some silver paint.
This is a Technicon spacecraft from the planet Technicon.
A short while later, they had UFOs they hoped would pass the toughest scrutiny. Once the paint and glue had dried, we gave the kids bamboo poles, fishing line, and cameras. Next, they took turns tossing and photographing a Cadillac hubcap. That's as sophisticated as we got, but the results were impressive. The children came up with several photos that could easily pass for classic UFO shots. We were ready to go public.
I mean, you guys have seen photographs and videos of UFOs.
I posed as a UFO author and displayed the photos at a shopping mall.
This is my new book coming out next month, The Hard Evidence. Take a look at these photographs, see what you think.
We've got, to bolster the photo's authenticity, I invented a story to go with them.
Who took that?
It's the foreman at this construction site. He was taking pictures of the house that they were building. And one of the guys said, look at this, and he snapped a couple shots.
How many people saw it?
Six different people. Yeah, so it wasn't like anybody's hallucinating or something.
I mean, this looks real.
It looks like some kind of flying saucer of some kind.
They look real, but how can you prove that they are real?
That's the big question. If we wanted our photographs accepted into the annals of UFO mythology, we needed a stamp of approval from experts. Dr. Rand Molnar of the Brooks Institute of Photography is frequently asked to verify alleged UFO photos. When he examines an image, he doesn't decide whether the subject is a real UFO or a tin pie plate, only whether the photo has been manipulated in some way. For instance, Molnar thinks this famous UFO photo looks suspicious.
There appears to be a lot of what I'll call density manipulation in where the item is. That is, it looks like somebody has been in there with some sort of a drawing tool, a pencil, eraser, and I just don't see that kind of activity anyplace else in the scene.
Would the computer be able to spot the tricks we use to fake our photos? First, we showed Dr. Molnar the hubcap shot.
It appears stationary. I don't really see any hint of movement.
But we know this object was moving because we threw it. On this count, the computer has been fooled. Now, here's our prize fake UFO shot. Remember, it's two plastic lids glued together, hanging from a string. Surely we are going to be found out.
No sign of a string still. Nothing to indicate a string, a wire, or anything.
Why can't the computer see the string? Because the camera that shot the original picture couldn't see it. Contrary to what you see on TV cop and spy shows, the computer can't detect a detail that the film never captured. No string on the negative, no string on the computer.
It looks a little more realistic in that it has a little bit of roughness to it. The granularity of the film matches the background and the foreground subject both, so it looks a little more real.
It looks real, but the plain fact is that most UFO photos are of such poor quality that it's impossible to tell if they're fake. But there's something strange about UFOs, something that makes us want to believe. For instance, you'd think the folks at the shopping mall would be relieved to know our photos were a hoax. Instead, they were disappointed.
What would you think if I told you that what you're looking at there is this?
Wow! I believe there's still life in other planets. I don't care about the pictures, though. I still believe there is.
I still believe in UFOs. I still believe in them.
I still believe they're out there.
You do?
You still believe? Yeah, I do.
While there may be alien life out there, now that we know how easily photos can be faked, it will take much more concrete evidence to prove it.